Yeah, welcome to this first outdoor tutorial on monitoring of forest resources. My name is Lutz Fehrmann and I'm standing here in a forest area about 20-25 kilometers northwest of Göttingen. And as you can see in the background, it is an even-aged spruce stand. In this video, I'm going to explain some very basic measurements on single trees. It is interesting to note that the actual target variable of an inventory or the target variable that we like to predict for a single tree can usually not be measured directly. This would be, for example, volume or biomass. In the field, we take simple measurements that we then feed into models that predict the target variable. Okay, the most common standard measure we are taking in forest inventories is the so-called diameter at breast height, the DBH, where breast height does not necessarily refer to your own personal body measure, but is a defined measurement height. It is interesting, even though it is the most common variable, this measurement height is internationally unambiguous, so it is not clearly defined. I have marked some positions on this tree here to make this more clear. If you come to Australia or New Zealand or Myanmar and also to India, the DBH is measured in 4.7 feet, which is here. If you ask a forester from Korea, for example, he or she will tell you that the DBH is measured in 1.3 meters, which is down here. Foresters in the US are measuring in 4.5 feet, which is here, and the rest of the world measuring in metric units is measuring in 1.3 meters, and this is what we will also adopt in our videos here. Okay, in a good inventory manual, you should also find more detailed descriptions on where to measure and how to determine the measurement height in special cases. For example, if you are working on a slope or if you find any deformations exactly in this height of the tree. If we are working in a slope terrain, we are usually measuring the height of 1.3 meters always from the upper side of the slope, since we are always also interested in the harvesting volume of this tree. You don't need to measure this on each single tree that you are going to measure. You can also measure it on your own body. I have a tape here and I can do this for you. So the 1.3 meters for me would be exactly here, and you can remember this position. From time to time you should carefully check whether it's still okay, and then you can use your own reference here to find the correct measurement height. Before we start to measure the DBH of this tree, you should ask yourself two important questions. The first one is, what does it mean at all if we talk about a diameter? Well, a diameter is a property of a circle. So the basic assumption here is that the cross-sectional area, and this is what we are essentially interested in, has a circular form. This might be a good approximation in case of this tree, but to be honest, I will not find any tree in this forest that has a perfect circular form. Usually they are more elliptic or irregular. That also means as soon as this basic assumption is violated, we take a wrong measurement of the true basal area of this tree, the cross-sectional area. The second interesting question is, what does it mean if we measure all the trees of different sizes always in the same absolute measurement height? Well, essentially it means that depending on the size of the tree, we are measuring in different relative positions. For a tree like this with a height of 26 meters or more, this is only 5% of the total height. If we compare this to a very small tree of maybe only 2.6 meters in height, it is 50% of the total height. And this has some implications if we like to derive or prove assumptions of allometric models. Allometry essentially means that we calculate a ratio between two relative growth rates of functional parts of an organism. If we measure in different relative positions, then it is quite obvious that this is not a functional measure of a tree. For this purpose, we would always need to measure in the same relative height, but this is very difficult to implement, since we would need to measure all the tree heights first to determine the measurement position. So, in summary, the DBH is a compromise for convenience because we can easily reach it and we can easily measure it on all of these trees. And it is still highly correlated to the actual target variable that we are interested in, like volume or biomass or carbon. Okay, the first tool I like to show you is a very basic tool. This is a caliper. Those students that have a background in forestry already know it. For others, it's maybe new. That's why I shortly introduce this caliper. Well, a caliper is a very simple tool. At the same time, it's also a quite big tool. It is not very handy to carry in the forest. So if you work in a tropical forest, for example, and you expect trees of higher dimensions, then it becomes very unpractical. But here, in this case, it's a very useful and simple instrument. Well, what does a caliper measure? It measures the distance from the left-hand side of the tree to the right-hand side of the tree. And we call this a diameter because we assume that we are measuring a circle. Okay, let's do a measurement with the caliper. If you use the caliper or any other tool, be sure about the correct measurement height. Always push the caliper completely to the stem, and then you can make your reading here on a scale. This first reading for this tree would be 49.2 centimeters. However, if I take a second measurement perpendicular to the first one, then I get 52 centimeters. So you see already that there is quite a difference in these both measurements because this is not a circular cross-section. Usually in an inventory protocol, there is an instruction in which direction you are measuring first. It might be, for example, that the caliper arm should always point to the center of the sample plot. And this is simply because direction matters. Whenever I measure from a different direction, I will get a different reading. And that makes it very difficult if we are interested in precise measurements of increment. So if we are going to repeat this measurement several times and we are not sure that we have exactly the same direction of measurement, we can introduce a bias in the estimation of increment, for example. Okay, the second tool that we can use to measure a DBH is a diameter tape. I have one of these tapes here, which is equipped with a hook. We also have smaller tapes. So what is a diameter tape? It takes a completely different measurement than the caliper, because with this tape, we are measuring the length of the convex hull around this irregular cross-sectional area. The diameter is special in regard to the scales. On one side of this instrument, we have a metric scale to measure distances or lengths. On the other side, we have a pi scale. So here, the metric scale is divided by 3.14, so by pi. And this enables us to directly read the diameter of a circle for which we measure the circumference. So again, here the basic assumption is that we are taking measurements on a circular cross-section. As soon as we are violating this basic assumption, we are overestimating the true basal area of this tree. Okay, let's take a measurement on this tree. I can hook it in here, 1.3 meter measurement height, and walk around. Once you are completely around, you should take your tape and stretch it. So you should be careful that it is really tight and straight. and that it is in one plane perpendicular to the axis of the stem, which also holds for the caliper. So once the tape is straight, we can make our reading here. Here we, where you see the zero, my reading here would be 51.3 centimeters. Yeah, there are special cases where the measurement of a diameter doesn't make sense at all. Unfortunately, I cannot show it here. But if you come to a tropical forest and you find buttress trees, so trees with very pronounced buttress roots that can reach up to 5 or even 9 meters, then the measurement of a circumference or the length of the cross-sectional area in a given height doesn't make any sense at all, since it does not tell us anything about the true basal area of such a tree. Okay, what can you do if you have none of these devices at all? I'd like to show you a short and very simple approach how to estimate roughly the DBH of a tree. So if you are at home and you have a tape, you can measure the width of your own handspan. So take a reading on a tape. My handspan is about 22 centimeters. And if I measure this here on the P scale, at home you can divide your measurement by P, then this is exactly 7 centimeters in my case. In addition to that, each single of my fingers covers around 0.5 centimeter of DBH. So with this simple reference of your own hand, you can now just count the number of handspans. I start here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I end up here with 7. 7 times 7 is 49. And I started here. So I have about 3 fingers more, which is 1.5 centimeters more. So my measurement here with my own handspan would be 49 plus 1.5, which is 50.5 centimeters. Okay. This is all what I wanted to tell you about the measurement of diameters. In the next videos, we will talk about other measurements on single trees. Thank you for watching so far, and see you back in the next video.